Where are you, Nick?
Yeah.
Hi, Nick, my name is Brandy.
Hi.
I'm a lieutenant with the St. Clair County Sheriff's Office, okay? You got some water, right?
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Have you had anything to eat?
No.
Okay, let me,
Can, I will wait for now.
Okay.
Food.
Are you sure?
I'm not hungry.
Okay. Well, if you get hungry.
Yeah.
Just let these guys know, okay, or let me know when I can,
It's just very, very thirsty.
Yeah, I bet. Plus it was a long.
Out on the river drinking beer all day and not drinking any water.
And it's hot and, yeah. Being in the sun all day, doesn't matter if you're drinking beer. Sometimes it's just, and then this, yeah. So I would imagine that you have some questions for me.
Well.
I am just gonna go through the rights form and, you know, let you know if you wanna answer any of my questions, we'll talk about that. I'm gonna record our conversation, if you're okay with that.
Of course.
Let's see, today is the 30th of July and it is 7:53 PM. How do you spell your first name?
N-I-C-O-L-A-E.
Okay.
Last name, no middle name.
No middle name, okay.
Yeah.
And what's your last name?
M-I-U.
How do you spell, or how do you pronounce that?
Miu.
Okay. And what's your birthday? Do you like to be called Nicolae or Nick or
Nick.
What? Nick, okay.
Yeah.
December 11th, 1969. Okay, so that makes you
52.
52, thank you. Yeah. What's your address, Nick?
5945 Hidden Oaks Circle, Southeast.
Holy cats, that's a multiple.
It's a long one.
Hidden Oaks Circle. I don't even know if I have enough space in this place.
You do. Southeast.
Southeast. Oh, Southeast. Thank you for correcting me.
No problem.
And that's
Prior Lake.
Prior Lake, okay. What's the zip code in Prior Lake?
55372.
Okay, and how about a phone number for you, Nick?
612-735-6317.
6317, and I understand you're married to Sandy.
Yes.
Right? Okay.
Yeah. Is she okay?
She is, yeah. I did talk to her. I talked to her for quite a while. I brought her to get dry clothes.
Okay, where is she?
She is with Ernesto and Amy.
Okay, good.
They're taking good care of her. And then,
Titi, my puppy.
She's headed home to take care of the dog.
Okay.
And she's also with, Ariel. And, who's her girlfriend?
Oh, God, I don't even know.
Is it Tatiana?
No, Tatiana. Tatiana is another girl.
Okay.
But she's
not.
Hold on,
they
Tatiana.
Gave me.
Yes.
Oh, Sandy didn't know Ariel's girlfriend's name.
Neither do I.
Okay. But Ernesto and Amy
came
to where I was with Sandy, and they went and got the car, but I had brought Sandy to the car to
she
get changed.
She was driving, right?
No, she was with me. I brought her from the river to the car
okay.
so she could get clothes, and we brought the cooler back and put that in the car, so she's got all the stuff.
All right.
Are you working anywhere now?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, where do you work?
I work at Reach Engineering as a mechanical engineer.
And what kind of engineering? What was
mechanical
that?
Engineer.
Yeah, what's the name of your employer?
Oh, Reachie.
R-I-T-C-H-I-E.
Engineering. In Blooming. I think it is.
Okay. What was the last grade that you completed?
I have a bachelor's, and I have actually 2 degrees, one
okay.
in engineering, one in mathematics.
Wow.
And I'm a class away from a master's in both. I'm not a dummy, and I've never run, never had a run with the law, except when I got the we'll go into
okay.
that.
So where did you get your degrees from, your undergraduate?
South Dakota State University.
Okay. Is that the Bison?
No, the Jackrabbit.
Okay.
In Brookings.
And how about your master's degree? Where are you working on
that? I'm not working on it yet.
Okay.
Yeah, I did pass the EIT so that I could work
gotcha.
For the state as a licensed engineer, but I haven't had a chance to do that. For many years, I worked as a contracting engineer.
Okay.
And then for the past 16 years, I've been working with Ritchie Engineering, where I met Sandy.
Okay. What does Ritchie Engineering do? Like, what do they manufacture?
What do we do? We do HVAC service equipment.
Okay.
Basically, we're the top tier of HVAC. We're like the top brand. And the top brand for that is Yellow Jacket.
Okay. And is that for the parts?
The brand of everything we make there, we make it under the Yellow Jacket brand.
Got it.
But okay. The company name is Ritchie Engineering.
Okay.
So what I do everything from hoses, recovery machines, all the electronics. I talk to customers. I get business. I do the documentation, the design. It's a small company,
okay.
So I like to do everything. Testing, evaluation, you name it.
Wow.
16 years over there, and that's not even scratching the surface.
Really?
Well, I have bigger dreams now,
yeah.
Shattered, but anyway, I don't want to talk about them right now.
Okay.
I don't know exactly what happened, I just don't. I can't talk about it. I need to go one step at a time.
Yep. And if you have any questions along the way, Nick,
yes.
Just stop and ask me, okay? Or if you need to take a break, just...
How bad is it?
Well, can we get through this form and ask each other questions?
Yes.
I want to maintain the integrity of this investigation and your rights, and, you know, so I want to get through this form, and then we can ask questions, okay? So I'm going to turn this around. I'll give you this pen. What I'll have you do is I'm going to read each... You seem to speak excellent English.
Yeah.
You can read.
Yeah, Miranda writes.
Yeah.
Which have not been read to me when I was put in the car.
And that's okay. As long as they weren't asking you any questions, they don't need to.
Oh.
But I'd like to ask you questions, so that's why we're going to go through this right now.
All
okay?
Right.
So I'll let you have that pen, and so I'm going to read these to you, okay?
Mm-hmm.
You have the right to remain silent.
Or just be...
You can check mark it, or some people put their initials. You know, we'll have you sign it at the bottom, so that's however you want to do that. Anything you say can be used against you in court or other proceedings.
Mm-hmm.
You have the right to consult an attorney before making any statement or answering any question, and you may have him or her present with you during questioning.
Okay.
And also, Tommy, I talk kind of
fast. Yeah, I was going to ask you about this one.
Okay.
So,
yep.
When do I see one? When do I get one assigned to me?
You would get one assigned to you the soonest would be on Monday.
Oh.
So that would be the soonest. And
working hours,
pretty much is how that works.
Okay.
So if you cannot afford to pay for an attorney, you may be eligible to be represented by an attorney from the office of the state public defender. If you desire an attorney from that office, you should contact their local office.
And that information would be provided to me, or?
Yes. So what happens is, the jail provides that information every day to the public defender's office. Like, here's who's on the list.
Okay.
So some people come into jail and they either have a lawyer already because of other things, or they know a lawyer, or they're going to find their own. So these guys will let you use the phone if that's
I'll ask Candy to look for me,
okay.
If that's okay.
Oh, gosh, yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, because I'm not going to see you in time.
Yeah. Nope, that's fine. If you decide to answer questions now, with or without an attorney, you still have the right to stop the questioning at any time or stop the questioning for the purpose of consulting an attorney.
Yeah, I'd like to do it at some point.
Okay. You can just check mark that. We went over that. However, you may waive the right to remain silent, and you may answer questions now without an attorney. You can just check mark that I read that to you. You're not agreeing to anything right now. This is just that I stated these things to you. So this says, the above rights have been read to me. I have initialed each paragraph, or in your case, check mark, to show that I understand each of my rights. I have received a copy of this form. So you sign it, and then I'm going to sign it, Nick, and then I'm going to give you a copy of it. All right, I'll sign here. And 801. All right,
committed to your time.
Hi, sorry, do you want me to write it regular? Okay.
No.
I get so caught up in used to that.
Yeah.
My friends don't like it, because in my vehicle, my own vehicle that I drive, it's military time, and so they're always asking me what time.
Everything I have is military, because I came from Europe.
Oh, sure, yeah.
They call it military, but it's not military.
Right, it's the...
The proper time.
Exactly. Well, good, at least then you know what it means then when I put the time on there like that. So I would like to ask you questions about your day today, what happened, you know, like how you guys got to be on the Apple River today, and then like what your day was like. It's up to you if you're willing to answer questions. If you decide that, yep, I'll answer questions right now, and in 10 minutes, you don't want to answer anymore, you just need to tell me that, okay? And if you don't want to answer questions right now, then that's fine too, and I will leave. It's up to you.
All I can say, it was self-defense. There were lots of people that came on to me. Self-defense, and they produced two weapons, one I took from them.
Okay.
That's the only thing I can tell. And they hit me, and they were on top of me, and I don't remember anything after that. I just remember I ran away. I ran away to my group. There were actually people coming over from my group to see what was going on. I said, nothing, just get back. And they kept asking, and I said, nothing. I didn't explain to them anything, because I was so fearful. I didn't know what these people would be doing to us. I've never been in a situation like this, where people produce weapons, and they were saying, they were calling, I don't remember, but they said, don't run from us, don't do this, you're a child molester, you're this, and again, I said, are you people drunk? Well, you're a child molester. I said, the only thing I remember in my mind is, if I'm a child molester, should you be drinking? Should you be drinking alcohol and doing what you're doing to people that you don't even know, attacking them? And I said, if I'm a child molester, you should be having alcohol, you know? And they took my, I was snorkeling, so they took my snorkel away, they threw it in the water, they grabbed my pants, one wanted to pull my pants down, and I grabbed onto him. And I don't know who that kid was, but he had a knife on him. And then there was another knife, a longer knife, looked like a kitchen knife. Kitchen or something, I don't know. And I don't know what happened to either one of them. I just know that when the kid attacked me, I took that from him.
The kitchen knife or the other knife?
No, the smaller knife.
Okay, what did that knife look like? Do you remember?
I don't even remember.
But it was smaller?
Smaller, yes.
Okay.
So, that's all.
How did you get to be by them? Or who are these people?
So, Ariel lost his phone.
Okay.
The phone was in the floor.
One of those bags?
Okay. And everyone had one, but his phone was in the floater, so he says, well, let's go look for it. So I put my smartphone on, and I looked, and this guy found something. And they were talking about it, and I said, okay.
This group of people?
Yeah. I went over and I said, did you guys find the phone? And if you did, can I see it? Can I identify it? And they started calling me names. They got off of their tubes. They came at me. I said, all I need. And they were calling me all kinds of names, insulting me for being in the water with a snorkel. And I said, all I want, guys, did you find the phone? And I saw they had found something.
Okay.
All right. And I don't know if there was a phone or something else they found, but they wouldn't talk to me about what they found. And we were looking desperately to find this phone. And I know somebody found it, but I thought it was that group.
Okay.
You know, and then they went over, they came to me, and they grabbed my snorkel, and they threw it in the water. Well, the water was so fast, it went under. So I went out after it, and they started, another group of mostly girls came over from the other side, yelling at me, or calling me child molester, and something like that. And I went back. I actually after this incident, I don't even know what happened.
Okay.
I just know that they attacked me, and I was in self-defense. I went into self-defense mode, and then I went over to my group of people. That was it. And they asked me what happened, and I wouldn't tell them. I said, I can't tell you. Let me calm down.
Okay.
I was shocked, so nobody on that knew exactly what happened. The only thing they said was, you know, somebody got in an argument over there, like, yep, let's just leave that alone. Don't go there.
Are you able to draw for me, like, where you were looking for the phone? Like, and where was Ernesto and Sandy, and where was this group? Maybe help me kind of understand.
Oh.
Yep.
These guys were here. I don't know how many. There were quite a few.
Okay.
We were upriver about 100 feet. Our group was here.
And so you guys were in the water?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
So we were in the water. And then there was another group of people over here that came to attack me. So there was this group of people here, this group of people that attacked me. They attacked me here.
So your group was floating down the river like this?
Actually, we're stopped. But yes, this is the
That's direction. The direction you were going. Okay, so your group is stopped.
Yeah.
And who's looking for the phone besides you? Like, how do you know the phone is missing?
Oh, yeah, we talked about it. I yelled.
Oh, okay.
Those phone books, and I lost my phone. And said, well, you didn't lose it. It's floating down the
river. Because it's in that bag.
Yeah, so let's go find it, you know. And he was over here pouting that he lost his phone, and I said, that's okay, I have my snorkeling gear. And then I heard this guy said that he found something. And when I was snorkeling down, I passed him. I kept looking, and then I came up, I kept looking, and then they started yelling and screaming, and I said, did you guys find something? And I thought they did. And I know they did, because they were hiding something from me. And then I went over there, and they grabbed my snorkel, they threw it down. They started, they got off their tubes, they came after me, they pushed me, one of them hit me, and then there was a girl that came from here and hit me in the back of my head. And I was about right there.
You said right here?
And when she hit me, yeah.
And that's when the female hit you?
Yeah. And she was coming from another group over here. I don't know how many people were in there.
But were these guys stopped?
Yes, in very shallow water.
Okay, so it's really shallow over here.
Shallow there.
Okay.
Pretty much the two sides are shallow. Yeah.
How deep do you think it was when you were like snorkeling around looking for the phone?
4 or 5 feet.
Okay.
Not very deep. And the water was very murky, so I could not see anything.
Really?
Under my goggles. But those goggles are lost. They took them, they grabbed them off my face and threw them in the water.
We found the goggles.
Oh, good. Thank you.
And the snorkel.
Yes.
Yep. Are they connected?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
And they're just like regular snorkel goggles, right?
Yeah. I had them over when I went to the Caribbean.
Okay.
Yeah.
What do they look like? Just to make sure we have
white.
The right one. White?
Transparent plastic with a white snorkel.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. Is that it?
I think we have
them.
Okay. Was there any... Did it seem like these groups were together?
After they came after me, I don't know. Yes.
Okay.
Yes, I think so. I mean, I feared for my life. Tell you the truth, when they started hitting me and pointed a knife at me, and then another kid pointed a knife, I thought that was it for me. Luckily, I took it from the one of the young kids, and I think that's when I swung back.
What did you do with it?
I don't even know.
Okay.
I don't know. Absolutely, I don't know. I don't know if you got it back. I have absolutely no idea.
Did you hit him? Like, did the knife make contact with him?
That I don't remember.
Okay.
You were so close.
Sure.
And one had it in his hand, so I took his hand and I bent it and I poked him with his own hand. And then I took it from his hand and then I went and swung like this. So I don't know who I hit. I just know that I took the knife from one of the kids.
Okay.
The other one, I don't know what happened to. I didn't get hit. Because as soon as this happened, I started running across. So I went across to my group. And then my group was wondering, what just happened? Was it? And I didn't want to tell them anything.
just that he didn't want to...
I didn't want to get anybody aroused. I didn't want my group to go say, well, we're going to go talk to those kids. No, they were too drunk, I believe. They were too drunk and too set on going after people, I think.
How did... What were these guys doing? Did they know anything was going on?
No.
So they didn't know you were getting punched or...
Well, they saw the scuffle because at one point Ernesto was coming towards me like, hey, man, did you find anything? And I said, no, I didn't. I don't know. These guys must have it or something. I don't know. And he says, okay, well, he will just get another phone by Monday. He were concerned about getting the phone. And like, okay, so what are you doing? I said, I don't know. I'm just going to go leave this shit in my thing. And then Sandy said, okay, are you okay? And said, I don't want to talk about it. You know, and then they asked me, hey, what do you want to do? You want to stay here? You want to go down? And I said, I want to go down. And then some girls from my group heard that something was happening over here, and they said, well, we're calling the police. And I think they called the police.
Okay.
One or two, I don't know.
Did you see any of that, what was going on?
No.
When they decided to call the police?
No.
Okay.
No.
Did you have a knife?
No, absolutely. No.
Okay.
I had one earlier that I used to cut, but right at the beginning, and I left it I don't even know what I did with it. I think I either gave it to one of the people, or I put it back in my truck.
Okay.
Yeah. So it may have been, I tell you the truth, I don't even know.
And that was after you cut the string?
Yeah, we needed to have something to cut the string over there. They don't have any knives. So.
But you have one with you today, right?
The what?
A knife to cut. How did that?
I think it's in my car.
Okay.
Yeah. I
think did you drive or did Sandy drive?
I did.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't even know where it's at, to tell the truth. It may be in one of the bags we had with us. It may have been I don't know. Maybe I left it, put it back in the car. Because I went back with a bunch of, I had straps. I didn't want to pay for string. But they say string
you
is
can't.
Cheap.
Well, they probably don't want you to have straps.
They told me, they said, yeah, if you have straps, there was a kid over there. If you have straps, no problem, but the string is free. So I said, okay, I'll take the string.
Okay.
You know, and then I took the straps back. So, because straps can puncture the...
Yeah.
So I had a whole bag of straps that I took back to my car.
Okay. And so maybe the knife was with the straps?
Probably.
Do you have any cuts or marks on you? Have you had a chance to like look at your torso or?
Somebody was telling me that I'm bleeding from my ear, from my left ear.
Who told you that?
Oh, I think it was Amy. They said, Nick, you're bleeding from your left ear. I went like this, and I went in the water, I cleaned, and then I don't see any blood, you know. And I don't know if you see any cuts, but
I don't.
Yeah, so I don't know why I was bleeding from my ear.
But Amy saw blood?
I think she says you're bleeding from your ear, Nick. And then I cleaned and I said, look, there is nothing. Oh, okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know if it was blood or if it was weeds she saw. I have no idea. We were like, she was on the other side, and I was just...
Yeah, so she's over here,
she's
right?
She's over here, yeah, right here.
Oh, so she's closest, Amy's over here, closest to the shore?
Yeah.
Okay.
With Ernesto right here, and I was over here somewhere in one of these.
Okay, and you got back in that tube then,
mm-hmm.
when it was time to go?
I got back in my own tube, yes.
Okay. did Ernesto come and get you?
No.
Like, did anybody know that you were getting punched or?
No.
Was anybody?
They wanted to talk to me about the phone, if I found the phone, and what did those guys say, and I said, they probably did, they don't want to give it up, they attacked me, and that's it. And then I said, let's go, I don't want to be here.
Yeah.
So they don't know what happened here.
You didn't tell anybody?
No.
Okay.
No. You're the first one to know.
Okay.
That's why probably Amy and everybody else is so surprised.
Well, they're worried about you.
Yeah.
I mean, and even Ernesto was like, I don't know how the hell this happened.
They don't know anything because I didn't know what to tell them.
Yeah.
I really don't know. Everything happened so fast. I really don't remember why they attacked me. I don't know why they took my snorkel away. I don't know why one of them wanted to pull my pants down. I don't know why they were being so mean. I just don't know.
Yeah.
I just don't know. And why did they want to scare me with a knife? I just don't know why they're scaring people on the river. It's a family-oriented river with knives and you know, what they did.
So was it two males that had knives?
I saw two males.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah.
And were they both from this group, or do you even know?
Well, that I don't know.
Okay.
One of them was from this group. The one that I took the smaller knife from, I think, was from this group.
Okay, so you took the smaller knife.
From one of them.
And is that the one that you said that you kind of went?
Yes.
Basically, like.
Oh, I was going like this. I wanted out. They were coming and they were punching me and they were circling me and they came really close. They were pushing me in the water and I just grabbed the kid's knife. I didn't even know if I was holding it right. I just grabbed it from him because he tried to poke me with it. So I feared for my life.
It sounds like
I was very shocked. I was extremely shocked. I couldn't even say anything to anybody. I had locked jaw. I don't know. Right now, I don't even know how this happened, how I got away from all that.
So when they were pushing you in the water, did you go underwater or did you remain standing?
No, I tripped.
Okay.
I tripped and I fell in the water a couple of times, yes.
Where on your body did they hit you?
In the back of my back. And I know one of the girls came over and slapped me right over my right ear. I couldn't even see what they were doing because I was tripping over the stones and I was falling down and they were just jumping on me.
I'm gonna show you a picture and see if you...
I was fearing for my life. I'm still fearful that they're going to find out who I am and go do something to Sandy. And possibly some of these people over here. I fear that somehow they're going to find out who I am and continue their whatever that was. And I don't know why they're so hateful. And I just don't get it. I mean, this is the second time I come to the river, the first time for my wife, and I promised her it was going to be a beautiful outing, and nothing to fear. We had lots of booze. She didn't drink because she was the designated driver, but most of us didn't. There was another girl that didn't drink on the other party because they wanted to drive home. We ate well, we had music, everything was so good. Of course, I had a lot of alcohol. Who doesn't, you know?
Well, you had a sober ride. So.
Yeah.
And I don't smell it on you. Were you drinking beer or vodka or what?
No.
Okay.
We don't do hard liquor because then we dehydrate too fast and then we get cramps.
Okay.
So after my quadruple bypass, I still have cramps.
Oh, yikes. Quadruple bypass? How long ago was that?
A year and a half ago.
Wow.
Yeah, so if you see any wires in my chest, in my sternum, that's from the wire.
Really? You have a pacemaker in there too or anything?
No. I tell you the truth, I'm scared because I'm not in the best of health, okay?
Yeah.
I'm just going down the river, probably should not have even drank that much beer, but the doctor never said don't drink.
Sure.
You know, especially beer, you can have as much as you want in moderation. I was in cold water, you know. So, but, you know,
Yeah, yikes.
And then missing vein here, and then from my leg.
Is that what they used to?
Yeah, take it here, take it from here, cut it in half. That's two. The same thing from my leg, mm-hmm. cut it in half, use the other two. So it's quadruple bypass.
Wow.
Yeah, I was dead. My heart stopped 5 hours.
Wow. Had you had a heart attack that mm-hmm. prompted that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yikes.
So I was in pretty bad shape.
It sounds like it.
Yeah.
I bet Sandy was pretty scared.
She was, because I was in the hospital for quite some time.
I bet.
At Methodist Hospital. But they did a great job, you know, and Methodist Hospital is probably one of the best hospitals for heart surgeries. If you know somebody, I'll point them to Methodist.
Yeah, my father-in-law had heart surgery there too. He had a heart attack a few years ago, and that's what he
did. So,
do you need some more?
No, that's it.
Are you sure? I got actually a fresh bottle here. So, you want it?
Yes, please.
I can't travel without one. It's brand new too. I didn't drink out of it yet.
Thank you so much.
I probably am going to drink out of it now. So, you can have that, and this is going to be my part.
I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah, I take a medication that makes me really, really thirsty. So I have bottles of water rolling around in my back seat. I've got them in the door pocket.
I'm supposed to take mine, but they're at home, and I don't know when I'm going to take them.
Okay, so you have medication that you need?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
By medication.
Because I can call Sandy and see...
I'm not going to have her drive over here.
Well, I might be able to send somebody to go get them.
Oh.
Just so that they get back here. And I mean,
she's shaking right now. She is... Probably.
Yeah. Well, we need to make sure you have your medication.
Yeah. But I would, like I said, I wouldn't have her drive.
Yeah. I might be able to send somebody there to get them. What medications do you take, Nick?
Oh my God.
Are they all heart related, or some do different things?
Two of them are heart related.
Okay.
Yeah. One is aspirin.
That's heart related, right?
Yeah. Potassium, because I'm getting a lot of muscle cramps.
Okay. That's four.
There is one. There's another one. I'll tell you when I remember.
Okay, no worries.
Yeah.
Were you on your phone at all during your day today? I know that Sandy didn't bring her phone.
I took some pictures.
Okay.
And then I put it away. Sandy does not like to take a lot of pictures, because then they get posted on
Facebook or Instagram or something.
Yeah. But I'm okay if they take them, if they post them. Yeah. I did take a few, didn't have a chance to do anything with them.
Okay.
Yeah, but I was not on the phone. I didn't call anybody.
Okay. Did you use your phone around the time?
No.
Like right before, you know, you were looking for the phone or anything like that?
No, not me. Not like these guys. They're constantly on their phones. That's why IDL lost his.
Because he was on it too much?
People can't enjoy life, you know, nowadays, going down the river without being on their phones. Of course, they take a lot of pictures, but the picture is not the same experience as being there, so...
Right. So do you think the pictures that you took were like at the beginning of your journey, or where do you think?
Oh, we did take, I took a couple of group ones where they have that music place in the bathrooms.
Okay.
We made a stop there to eat sandwiches. There were a lot of people over there. That beach was completely full. Lots of people there, lots of people. It was a beautiful day, except
it was.
This. And this now, we'll probably close that place down.
You think so?
Yes. Well, I don't know what resulted of it, because I don't know.
Is this you?
Yes.
Okay. What do you think was happening at that time?
They were fighting me. They pointed the knife at me. They pointed the knife at me. Both boys pointed the knife at me.
Okay. Did you see anyone take this picture of you?
No, God, no. I was actually very, very scared.
Yeah.
I was very scared. I didn't know what to think. I didn't know what they were doing and why. I mean, I understand they were drunk, but you get drunk, I get drunk, we all get drunk. We don't do that kind of stuff, especially on a family, a river like this, family outing. We don't do that kind of stuff. But I was very, you see, I was very, very scared. I didn't know what was going to happen next.
Did you see the woman that hit you in the ear? Did you see her at all?
No. I turned around, she hit me again.
Okay. Do you remember what her bathing suit looked like?
No.
What she was wearing?
She was just yelling at me and calling me a child molester. That's how it all started. They kept calling me a child molester. I don't know, out of the blue. And then they wanted to beat me up because they said I'm a child molester. And then my argument back to them was, if I'm a child molester and you're children, you shouldn't be drinking. You should not be out here drinking, okay? And doing what you're doing. Where are your parents?
Did they look like they were young?
Oh, they were, I don't know. I think they look pretty young to me.
Okay.
I don't think they were of the age of drinking.
Really?
Yeah. I don't know. I don't hang out with people like that. My generation and the people I hang out with are much older people.
Like Ernesto and Sandy.
Like Ernesto and Sandy and
Amy.
Yeah. Yeah. Amy's probably one of the youngest ones there.
Sure.
45 and Sandy is 61.
Yeah.
So I'm younger, you know.
So you said that they were standing really close to you.
They were on top of me. They were pushing me, shoving me. I tripped. I fell down. I got up. And that's where I saw the one of the kids there. It was the closest kid with the knife. And I grabbed it from him.
And that was the smaller
kid? Yes,
one.
Yes.
And he was in front of you. Was he as close as we are? Or
he was closer. He was closer. But as soon as he came with the knife, I grabbed the knife from him. And what I did then, I mean, I shouldn't show you, but I grabbed, twisted his arm and poked him with his own knife. Then I took it from him and I started swinging.
Okay.
So I swung. I don't even know who I hit.
Okay.
I don't know if I hit the girl that hit me twice in the head from behind. I don't know if I hit another kid. I don't know. They were just on top of me. They chased me, hitting me, and yelling at me and calling me, insulting me. That's it. So I don't know what knife they had. I don't know. I just saw two knives. That's it. A longer one and the shorter one.
Okay.
I don't know where they are. I don't know who's got them. I don't know.
So what I'd like to do is I'd like to get a sample of your DNA, because if these knives don't belong to you,
mm-hmm.
I would imagine your DNA is not going to be on them.
Well, I touched one of them.
Yeah, you touched the one you grabbed.
Yeah, from the kid.
Him.
Yeah.
Would you be willing to give me a sample of your DNA? Okay.
Yeah. Is that the good thing? I don't know. I don't have a lawyer over here to us.
Yeah, and certainly, so.
Should I wait?
Well, I've got a colleague that's in the process of writing a search warrant. So we're going to get it one way or another.
Mm-hmm.
I just thought if I could ask you, and we could just do it right now, I'll just, like, show you how to, like, what we would do.
I know what it
is. I would just get your DNA sample.
Yeah.
It's like a big Q-tip.
Yeah.
We'd also like to do an exam, have a nurse examine your body.
That's absolutely okay.
Okay. And I want her to look in your ears, and I want her to look at your back, and you know, the people that are in these groups, we're going to try to collect evidence from them because they might have your skin underneath their fingernails,
mm-hmm.
or, you know, we're going to do our best to get any evidence. So, I mean, we
yeah,
don't know
yeah,
what
of
happened.
Course, yeah, yeah, I mean, and I know everything that happened in the river, so.
Well, yeah. There's that part of it, too.
Yeah.
But,
definitely.
Okay.
Yep, yeah.
Okay.
You can tell me.
Okay.
I just don't know if I had a lawyer present what he or she would say.
Well, what I just want you to know that we would get it anyway.
Okay.
I've got a coworker that's writing a search warrant.
If you would get it anyway, then let's do it.
Okay. With the court order or just let's do it now and get it done.
No, let's do it now and give you what you need.
Okay.
To start your proceedings or your search.
Yeah. Well, and yeah, I mean, if you sound like you were really afraid.
Yeah, I have a quadruple bypass. I have been out of shape. I have been in bed for a long time, for 6 months at least. I couldn't go to work. I'm not in the best, I mean, I was just floating down the river. Nothing much. Every once in a while I got up so I could pee because I can't pee in the tender, you know. Shouldn't tell you that on camera, but yes, most people have to get off the thing. So I got out, I would get up and then hold on and then get back in. I mean, I don't do anything to stay in shape. I'm a guy that wants to survive and keep working at Reach Engineering, you know, and why these things happen, it's beyond me. I mean, I don't understand. I mean, why would that many people come down on one person that didn't absolutely do anything, take his goggles, almost one wanted to pull my pants down.
Did your trunks have like a drawstring?
Yeah.
So they didn't come down?
No. They came down a little bit, but no, because I have a drawstring on it, so yeah, they couldn't pull it down. But why? All of a sudden, they were like wolves around me, and they were attacking me from all their directions, and I truly, truly feared for my life. I didn't know what to do. I mean, these guys were talking over there. I didn't know what to say. I mean, I was just...
Which guys are you talking
to? My guys. So, and they were quite a bit of business, so they didn't see anything. I don't think they saw anything. And...
So, would you go back to your tube? Do you guys get the hell out of there?
Or no.
Or do you, like, what do you do?
We stayed there.
Okay.
Yeah, the girls called the cops. We didn't know what to do. And we stayed there for a long time. There were people coming. We even saw the sheriff coming. And they kept saying, oh my God, they didn't know what happened. So they said, oh my God, what happened? So there was a fight. And I said, yeah, I don't know what was going on after that. I thought they were still fighting. I personally, when I came back, I saw a whole bunch of people coming over there and yelling at each other. And I thought they were still fighting for some reason. I didn't know what was going on. So I personally wanted to stay and watch to see if the cops get them for fighting, you know, for whatever they were doing.
Sure. Okay.
So I wanted to be a witness to them fighting.
Gotcha.
Or if the cops needed a witness, I wanted to sit there for as long as possible. And then the group said, well, there's so many people, I don't know, let's just get going. We don't want to get involved in this. I was just in there. They attacked me. Yeah, but look at them now, they're attacking each other. I don't know what they're doing. So cops came and we stayed there for, I don't know, another 10, 15 minutes.
When the police were there?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And then we decided, we'll go. Nobody asked me anything and I said, I kept my mouth shut. And down the river we went.
Okay.
So I was very shocked. I didn't know what just happened, really, to tell you the truth.
Well, Sandy said that you were quiet.
I was very quiet.
And you didn't really talk.
I didn't know what to say.
Yeah.
I mean, I get my ass kicked by a whole bunch of kids. What am I going to say? I just got my ass kicked by this kid. Now the police is on top of them. Well, I think something is going to come out of it.
Yeah.
So I thought the police was there because they were fighting, you know, because these were just boys. And they were being obnoxious, not only picking on me, then these girls came over and hit me.
So these are girls over here?
Well...
Mostly? Okay. And this was all guys?
Yeah, I didn't know who was in this group, but I know these were all guys because I was snorkeling back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
And I asked them if they found something, and they said, well, you know, they started calling me a molester. Then I got up and one of them took my goggles, threw them in the river. I went after them. One of them wanted to pull my pants down. And there you go. So what happened? Can you tell me what happened?
Yeah. four people went to the hospital with injuries.
Oh, my God.
And one person died.
Oh, no.
I don't know any of their names, and I don't know any genders, so I don't know.
Was that because they fought each other, or is that the...
I don't know. I don't know what their injuries are. I was with Sandy the whole time, and then when I kind of turned Sandy over to Ernesto and Amy, then I came here. So I have no idea what their injuries were.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
So we just need to be able to, like, piece this together, you know, in your statement.
What other pictures did they give you of me?
Just that one. That's the only one I have.
They didn't take... They have other cameras. You should take their cameras.
Yes, and so I have colleagues,
yeah,
investigators that are talking to all of those, you know, the people in the group and the other witnesses. So, yes, we are trying to collect. And I told Ernesto and Amy, because they said that... Rosie,
yeah.
Pictures?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I don't think she took any pictures of those guys. There was at the stop up here.
Yes, but you were snorkeling. They might have been like taking a
selfie
or something,
and
we could get these guys in the background that they don't even realize they have it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I see what you mean.
So I asked them to go through their photos
in contact with them. Got it. All of a sudden, you say that, like, why would they take pictures of me going over there?
No, you just never know what you get in a picture. Yeah. If they're sitting here waiting for you and somebody else to find the phone.
Did you find his phone?
I don't know. Again, I've been with Sandy pretty much the whole time, and now I came here with you. So I do know, I did get a message that the goggles and the snorkel were found. So that's all the information that I have about, like, items that were located.
Now my whole life is down the tubes.
Well, I don't know if that's the case. Because people have the right to defend themselves.
I know, but this is Wisconsin.
This is Wisconsin.
Okay. You continue on. I usually know that people that defend themselves, they end up being accused of being this and being that.
Well, I think if you'd asked me what I would have done, I don't know.
I
would have been scared shitless, I can tell
you that. When that many people tried to pull your pants down and hit you, and and two boys had knives on them, they didn't find any of those two knives?
I don't know, but we're looking. And, you know, we're looking before it gets dark out.
I'm glad I actually took that kid's knife. He would have stabbed me. He was not there to scare me. He was there to harm me. At least I'm here. But I'm sorry for how it ended up. Still scared, like I said, I'm scared that they're gonna be finding out where I live, and they're gonna be hunting us at night, and they're gonna be hurting my wife.
Well, I will call Sandy as soon as I meet her, okay, and just check in on her, find out about your medications. Have you had any medicine this morning?
No, I take them in the evening.
Okay, take them in the evening. Yeah. What would happen if you don't take them
tonight? Nothing. I'm not even hungry.
Okay. But if you don't take your medication tonight, is that life-threatening?
I don't think so. No, I mean, granted what happened today, you know, I was shocked, yeah, but I don't know. I don't think so. I just can't believe what happened. You know, they need to maybe do sobriety tests on minors on that river. Maybe they need to put an end to drinking, underage drinking and doing drugs. The river over there is turned into a sewer. My second time, and I have dragged my wife out of there pretty much against her will. I promised her it was going to be the best day. I made promises. We're going to have a great time with this.
But she didn't want to go.
No. She always says, oh, places like this, all they do is smoke pot and do this. Yes, there is a lot of pot smoking over there. We don't know who's legal, who's illegal. I don't know anything about Wisconsin laws, but you can smell it. It was everywhere in the air. And I don't know what people do, because you do the DNA, you can find out, you know, what type of drugs are in my system. I've never done any of that stuff, so I don't know. I'm very clean, and as clean as they go, you looked at my criminal record, you can keep digging, there is nothing there, because I don't have anything, not even a parking ticket, not a speeding ticket. You know, I'm as law-abiding citizen as they come. But I fear for my life, too. I mean, I went through a very serious surgery to be alive, to be knocked down by a bunch of kids on the river.
I understand.
And I'm not blaming the police. I believe that's a private land. They have to have their own security there.
Yeah.
And they need to do better.
So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to rub these along your lower gum line and kind of inside your cheek. I'm going to do them both at the same time. It shouldn't hurt at all. If it doesn't, let me know. I'm going to put them in this box, and then I'm going to seal this bag while we're sitting here so you can see that I sealed it, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So I'll just have you open up your mouth. Let's see here. Shouldn't hurt. All right. And you're okay with having the nurse do the exam on you? Give me pictures if you're in lumps on the body. You're okay with that?
Yeah. These actually are from drag, from trying to get out of the tubes in shallow water.
Okay.
You know, I had a hard time trying to stop the drain.
Yeah. I know the nurse will too, but can I take a picture of it?
Yes.
Okay.
But this was not from the confrontation.
Oh, this wasn't?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry. I misunderstood that.
No, these are from scrapes on the river bottom. When I was
snorkeling. I got
you.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah, please don't use that. Yeah. I didn't touch those kids. I did not. I did not claim nothing. No.
Okay. I'm going to seal this up, because I told you I was going to do that. And then I'm going to go call the person that has the nurse kind of on standby so that we can get that taken care of. I'm also going to give Sandy a holler. Oh, look at that. The tape just went.
Oh,
for the love of God.
Is this good?
Well, I didn't like it because it's not going to be big enough to do what I need to do here, so we'll try it again. Worst case scenario, I can always bring it my office next door and do it in the evidence room, but I'm going to try to take care of it here.
Probably dries up. When it dries up, it's probably...
Well, and then it's real sticky and it's real finicky, so if you get it stuck on something, it's, you know, it's meant to not be able to tamper with.
Mm-hmm.
So. Get ripped on my fingers. So I'll just.
It goes so fast.
Okay. So I'm going to go call my supervisor, who had been in contact with the nurse, and just let them know that we're going to do that. And then I will be back. Do you have any questions now?
I do not.
You need to go by. I can make sure that happens. I'm just going to write your name on here so that... Today is 7/30/22.
M.I.U.
Yep, this is, that needs no middle initial.
Oh, I did.
Oh, did I spell it wrong?
No, no.
Yep, I did. It's M.I.U. There we go. Okay, that's yours. I will be back in a minute. In the meantime, I'll have one of the jail staff bring you to the bathroom. And are you still doing okay? Do you need, how's your water there?
I have nothing for now.
Okay.
It's going through a lot faster than I thought.
Alright, I'll be right back, Nick.
Thank you so much.
Can you use the restroom?
Lieutenant Hart, was that the interview you did with Nicolae Miu at the jail?
Yes.
At the point where you left, was that the end of your questioning?
Yes.
While you were talking to him, you showed Mr. Miu a photo on your phone?
Yes.
What was that photo?
That was a photo that had been disseminated to us of the suspect.
You know where it came from? At the time, did you know where it came from?
Probably. I believe dispatch had emailed it out.
Was it a photo from the video?
Objection.
Or from something else?
Sustained.
You know where the photo originated from?
I do.
Where did it originate?
From Jawan Cockfield's video.
While you're talking to Mr. Miu, you were referring to a diagram?
Yeah.
Are you going to approach her?
Yes.
Lieutenant Hart, I'm showing you what's been marked as Exhibit 16. Do you recognize that?
I do.
And what is it?
This is the diagram that I asked him to draw me while we were talking.
Did he draw portions of that?
He drew all of it. I put the words on there.
All right. Your Honor, I move for admission of Exhibit 16.
Any objection? 16 is received.
If I can publish to the jury on the yellow?
Yes, you may. While you're standing there, would you also retrieve the Exhibit 24?
Is the only thing you added the words on the diagram?
Yes, he put the 100 feet or inches, but I wrote Amy, the mostly girls, shallow, all males and female, and then that is my handwriting on the lower right-hand portion where I put the date and our agency case number.
Also in the video, you appeared to be taking a buckle swab.
Yes.
Did you do anything with those swabs?
I logged them into evidence at the sheriff's office.
Were those the swabs that were sent to crime lab?
No.
Which swabs were sent to the crime lab?
The one in the kit that the SART nurse had taken.
While you're speaking with Mr. Miu, did you notice any signs of impairment?
No.